So Sheikh Mufti Mank, if you could throw some light on this aspect, why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us into difficulties? Why would somebody get into trouble?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulullah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. The question here is about why would Allah put us into difficulty if He is so merciful? And in order to answer that, I can give you a few examples, because with these examples, we will be able to relate it to our own lives. Number one, how many of us have been far from Allah, very far from Allah, and suddenly we lose a job, and we have so much to pay in terms of installments, maybe for something we have purchased, or maybe we have some commitments, rentals, etc. And we realize at a certain time that, you know what, I need another job very urgently, and I don't have this job, and we start rushing from pillar to post with Allah still outside the equation. And a time comes when we realize our helplessness, and then we change our lives, we make dua. For the first time in our lives, we actually say, oh Allah. Now, all of that was the mercy of Allah. If it took a big problem of losing a job to bring you all the way to come closer to Allah and to call out to Him for the first time, wasn't it worth it? So now you call out to Allah and you still don't get the job and you still have difficulty. You have to have hope in Allah. You will now start perhaps praying 5 times a day when you didn't pray 5 times a day, because this problem gave you the opportunity to consider yourself and where you are standing. You are starting to say, maybe something is wrong. Perhaps something is wrong. You know, let me try and correct myself. People have a bad habit, they give up the bad habit. People have addictions, they give up the addictions and they come back to Allah. I know of people, myself included, sometimes we get up for tahajjud when there is a problem and we are crying to Allah, oh Allah, help us through this day, help us through this issue. So yes, tahajjud, and that is the early morning prayer, the pre-fajr prayer, it is not compulsory. But wasn't it the mercy of the Almighty that put you into the problem and did not solve the problem until you tasted the sweetness of your salah and until you tasted the sweetness of the connection with Allah, and then He decided to grant ease after 20 years of suffering? I know of a couple who didn't have children for 14 years and they cried, and sometimes they went through so much of difficulty. Before I carry on with the story, may Allah bless all those who don't have children with children. Say Ameen. So the 14 years later, they were blessed with a child. And I'm thinking to myself, look at how close they became to Allah, because they realized IVF didn't help, this doctor didn't help, the specialist didn't help, nothing helped. It made us come close to Allah. So talking about hardship, it took Allah 1 second to sort the matter out. But in the process, He gave you the opportunity to come so close to Him that had it not been for that problem, perhaps you would not have come close. So that is the mercy of Allah. And I can go on and on. In our own lives, sickness has the same effect. Person is diagnosed with something, the doctors have given up, you are sick, you are ill. For the first time you say, oh Allah, forgive me. The doctor tells you, you are terminally ill. You go to people and say, forgive me, I might die, forgive this, forgive that, and so on. You've made peace, you start becoming a better person. That was the mercy of Allah. That was not a punishment of Allah. It was in fact directly the blessing of Allah. So much so, even if we died without the problem of the world being sorted out, the fact that we became closer to Allah through that problem, at least we did not lose the hereafter. So I give you another example. A person who died suddenly, just like that, while sinning, they are in a worse position than a person who got sick and ill and called out to Allah 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and became so close to Allah. Then the dua was given in a different way by them being taken away, but they got Jannatul Firdaus. Those 3 years at the end were the biggest blessing of that person's life. The life changed, the sadaqah began, the charities began, the goodness began, and so many other people around may have changed as well. helpless people. I give you one example. We have a brother called Ali Banat. You might have heard about him. You might have seen something of him. His life was moving in a different direction according to him, rahmatullahi alayhi. Suddenly he was diagnosed cancer, given a very short time to live, and he was a multi-millionaire. He decided, my life is changing today. Wasn't that the mercy of Allah? He made dua, we made dua, the whole world made dua for him to be cured. But to be very honest, even though he died as a result of that cancer, Allah extended his time compared to what the doctors had said. And he happened to build masjids and schools and help the orphans and orphan. And he spent most of his wealth, you know, in the right direction. He died a happy man. He left a note for you and I. He left a video for you and I to watch after his death, to tell you his story. What was that? If that was not the mercy of Allah, what was it? Barakallahu feek.
Jazakallah khair.